is our enemy.
Qu'est-ce qu'on peut faire avec nos ennemis?
Do we watch them continue to celebrate while you remain one corner crying?
Nous allons passer dans un coin, aller voir célébrer, et nous on reste dans un coin à pleurer.
Amen. I want to let you know this morning that the enemy is having sleepless nights because of you. Oh, you are saying amen to that. Anyway, when I say amen or not, it is the truth. The enemy is having sleepless nights because of you. He's walking day and night. To see that he brings you down. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he's doing everything possible to see you down.
Pour vous voir anéanti.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So what do you do?
Donc, qu'est-ce que vous faites?
Do you relax?
Est-ce que vous allez rester relaxé?
And watch.
Et regarder.
Amen.
Amen.
Some people say, let my enemy live long. So see what I will become.
Certaines personnes m'ont dit que nos ennemis vivent si longtemps pour voir ce que tu vas devenir.
If that enemy is not a real enemy,
cet ennemi n'est pas vraiment le vrai ennemi.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I want us to know that the enemies are right there. At night they are not sleeping, they are having meetings.
Ils sont là, ils sont trois là. Ils sont, la nuit ne dorment pas.
They are doing everything.
Ils font tout dans leur pouvoir.
To see that we are down.
Pour voir que nous sommes anéantis.
Therefore, you as a Christian,
dans ce cas, vous en tant que chrétien,
you must take that weapon.
Vous devriez en prendre votre bataille.
To deal with the enemy.
Pour combattre les ennemis.
Amen.
Amen.
We must take the fight to their camp.
La bataille pour aller dans leur.
Let's open our Bible. First Samuel.
Premier Samuel.
Chapter 30.
Chapitre 30.
First Samuel.
Premier Samuel, chapitre 30.
Samuel is before Kings. And it's after Ruth. Not Sister Ruth. After the book of Ruth.
Premier Samuel, c'est après le livre de Ruth.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
We are going to read verse 30. We start from verse 1. But before we read, I want to tell us the story that happened before this place.
Nous allons lire à partir du chapitre 30 à partir du verset 1. Mais avant de continuer, je vais vous dire une petite histoire.
Amen. We all know Saul.
Nous connaissions
tous. The king chosen by God.
Le roi que le Seigneur.
But he disobeyed God.
Et qui a désobéi à Dieu.
And what happened? God left him.
Dieu a laissé tomber.
Amen. And the Bible tells us that the spirit, the evil spirit of God tormented him.
Et la Bible nous a dit que les esprits démoniaux de Dieu les a tourmentés.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So people might be wondering, does God have evil spirit?
Oui, les gens vont dire, mais le Seigneur a des esprits.
That's why, you know, the Bible even told us that there are demons in heaven and there are demons on earth.
C'est pour ça la Bible nous dit que il y a des démons.
That's why when our mommy was talking the other time, we were talking about the Queen of Heaven. Many of us didn't understand.
Les anges du ciel.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Alleluia.
Yes, there are evil spirits that live up there.
Oui, il y a des esprits malsains qui sont là.
This God sent to torment Saul.
Ça, ce sont des esprits que le Seigneur a envoyé pour tourmenter.
And as a result, Saul was jealous of David.
Saul, il était jaloux de David.
And he wanted to kill David.
Et il a voulu tuer David.
Praise the Lord.
Alleluia.
And David had to flee.
Et David a pris la fuite.
He fled around to Gath.
Il a fui pour aller à Gath.
One of the regions of the Philistines.
C'est une des régions de Philistines.
Hallelujah. Because he knew that if he steps out of Israel, the territory of Israel, Saul will no longer look for him.
Parce qu'il savait très bien que si il quittait le territoire des Israélites, Saul ne va plus le chercher.
Hallelujah. He then went and hid himself in Gath.
Donc il va se cacher lui-même dans le pays qui s'appelle Gath.
And in this place there is a king called Achish.
Et dans cet endroit où il y a un roi qui s'appelle Achish.
And this king
et ce roi
welcomed David and his men.
Il a souhaité bienvenue à David et ses hommes.
But David said, I cannot stay with you here. I am not worthy. I don't want to take over your throne. Just give me a place where I will go with my men. And that king gave him Ziklag.
Il a dit simplement, donne-moi un endroit là où je pouvais vivre.
Donc, a small village called Ziklag.
The
people that were there, David and his men drove them away and took over the place. That is to say, the Spirit of God was with David.
Cela veut dire que l'Esprit de Dieu était avec David.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
After with Jacob came a time where the Amalekites were to fight with the Philistines.
Donc il est venu à un moment donné que il y a eu un bataille qui doit passer.
I want you to know that in those days, people are always fighting to reclaim lands.
Amen.
And David thought in his heart, this man that gave me this place, now the Amalekites want to fight them.
David l'a réfléchi, il a dit, mais cet homme m'a donné cet endroit. Et maintenant, les Américains, ils viennent maintenant pour venir se battre.
I need to help him to fight.
Je dois l'aider à combattre.
Hallelujah, somebody.
Amen.
David wanted to reciprocate the good that man did for him.
David, il a voulu repayer cet homme du bien qu'il lui a fait.
But unfortunately,
mais malheureusement,
the soldiers of the Philistines.
Les armées de Philistiens.
He said, no, we will not allow this man to fight with us.
Ils ont dit, mais non, on ne va pas laisser.
Is it not this same David? Amen. Is it not this same David that defeated a lot of, that fought a lot of war and won, that people were praising him even more than so?
Il dit, mais c'est pas cet même David qui a combattu auparavant, qui a conquéri pas mal de pays.
That people were shouting, Saul killed 1,000, David killed 10,000.
Il disait, mais Saul a tué 1,000 et que David a tué plus de 10,000.
So the Philistines, they never had confidence
à cause de ça, les Philistines n'ont jamais
in David.
La confiance
en David. Make this man not come overthrow us.
Il dit, c'est lui, il va finir par prendre le pouvoir parce que c'est lui.
So the soldiers didn't allow David. And Achish now said, oh David, I know that you have a good heart towards us. You want to fight with us. But my soldiers said no. Please go back to your Ziklag.
S'il vous plaît, il faut retourner dans votre pays.
But on getting back to Ziklag,
mais pendant son chemin pour arriver à Ziklag,
the Amalekites were already there.
Les Amalekites, ils sont déjà là.
They have attacked their small village.
Ils ont déjà attaqué le village.
Taking their wives and their children.
Leurs femmes et leurs enfants.
Even David's two wives were taken.
Les deux femmes de David ont été prises.
And his children were taken.
Même ses enfants ont été pris.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we read this passage, let you see. The Bible says David was crying like a baby.
David pleurait comme un enfant.
Let us read. Amen.
Amen.
1 Samuel chapter 30, from verse 1. David and his men reached Ziklag on the third day. Now the Amalekites had raided the Negev and Ziklag. They had attacked Ziklag and burned it, and had taken captive the women and all who were in it, both young and old. They killed none of them, but carried them off as they went on their way. When David and his men came to Ziklag, they found it destroyed by fire, and their wives and sons and daughters taken captive. So David and his men wept aloud until they had no strength left to weep. David's two wives had been captured, Ahinoam of Jezreel and Abigail, the widow of Nabal of Carmel. David was greatly distressed because the men were talking of stoning him. Each one was bitter in spirit because of his sons and daughters. But David found strength in the Lord his God. Then David said to Abiathar the priest, the son of Ahimelech, "Bring me the ephod." Abiathar brought it to him, and David inquired of the Lord, "Shall I pursue this raiding party? Will I overtake them?" "Pursue them," he answered. "You will certainly overtake them and succeed in the rescue." Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Bible said, David was weeping. He was crying. He cried aloud. So the extent that he no longer has strength to cry. Hallelujah. Like many of us today, our situation is making us to cry. We are crying like babies. We are weeping at every moment. But I came to tell us, weeping and crying is not enough. Take the fight to the enemy. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. If David had continued to cry and cry again, maybe he would have been dead. And not only him dying, his wives and the children and the wives and children of those other soldiers that were taken would have been killed. Hallelujah. Amen. Many of us today, we are too relaxed concerning our situation. Hallelujah. We are too relaxed. When they say praise, God, you understand. Just take control. It is not enough. The Bible says, right from the time of John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. And it's only the violent one that will take it by force. Hallelujah. Amen. Your crying will not get you back all that you have lost. Let me tell you, the enemy is not seeing your crying. He's even happy that you are crying. So he will want to see you cry continuously. Hallelujah. And he will continue to keep it and say, "Hey, he never cried today. Let me see the cry again today." Hallelujah. Jesus said, "We come, enter your room." Hallelujah. The third day we come, enter your three. That cry never enter your three. Don't cry very well. Hallelujah. But when you now come and say, "No, enough is enough." And you go, take the fight to his camp. If God can open your spiritual eyes, you will see the way all of them will be tumbling on the floor because of your prayers. Hallelujah. David said, "No, I just," he consulted God. He said, "God, what do I do? Can I pursue these people? Can I be able to rescue my people?" Hallelujah. You see, David consulted God. For many of us today, when we are in situations, instead of consulting God, we begin to consult those idiots. Hallelujah. Those people who don't even eat good food.